I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to download and read the Freestyle Libre blood sugar reports so that you and your medical team can make meaningful, data-driven adjustments to your diabetes management. In this video, I will cover three things: how to download your Freestyle Libre report, how to read it, and then finally, I'm going to show you an example. I'm going to share with you a report from one of my coaching clients. Allow me to share the report with you so that you can see how much and how fast of a change you can see to your blood sugar numbers when you start paying attention to your data. I've added timestamps to this video down in the video description. So for example, if you're only interested in learning how to read the Libre report, just go down to the video description, click on that timestamp, and you'll be taken directly to that part of the video. Your doctor can download your Libre report in the office, but you also have the option of downloading the report whenever you want to. That empowers you to go and look at your data and assess whether or not there's something you want to do more of, or maybe places where you want to make a few changes. Some people make changes to their diabetes management without their medical team. I'm one of those people, while others rely on their medical team for any changes. So even if you rely on your medical team, downloading that data, sending that over to your medical team and highlighting where you would like them to focus, that can help take your diabetes management to the next level. But first step first, let's start out by downloading that Libre report. Open a browser and then you type in LibreView.com. So here we go. And it's loading. This is what it looks like. So you want to sign up if you haven't done that. I have signed up, so you can see down here it's populating my email already and my password. So I'm just going to click login. And you see here I have a two-factor authentication. I recommend that. So I ask it to send me a code. It'll send that to my cell phone. Wait for that. Okay, here it is. Let me type that in. It's a one-time code, so you can see that. And then I simply click download, and here we go. So if you use the reader, you want to upload your device, and this is basically taking you through how to do that. So if you have it uploaded, or if you're using the app, you simply click up here in the left-hand corner, and here all your glucose history is then going to be, well, shown. So you can choose how much time you want to see. So if we click on this one, see, we can go all the way up to 90 days. Let's click on that. Then you can choose the different months out here. You'll see I don't have a lot of data in here because I don't use the Libre regularly, but you can choose whatever month you want and then click glucose reports. And then it starts to load. Loading, here we go. So this is the ATP report. You can click on whatever report you want to see, the patterns, monthly summary, daily logs, etc. So you can also change, you know, the dates that you want to see. We can set it to whatever we want. You can change the settings. So there's a lot of different options here. Just go in and choose whatever you want. I would do 90 days. So once you've chosen which kind of report you want, you click down here in the right-hand corner. That's a print or send a PDF. I like this because then you get it download in a PDF format. It's pretty easy to read. So here we go. This is my report. Click on that. And this is a PDF. You see, that's all the different reports out here to the left. I simply download that, click here, or you can click print if you just want to print the report. But that's how you do that. Now let's dig in. So one of my coaching clients allowed me to share her report. I crossed out her name and her date of birth, so it's completely anonymous. But I'm so excited that I'm allowed to share this report because, first of all, it's a great example of what you can see in a Libre report. But if you stick around for the next section of this video, it's also an excellent example of how much you can get out of paying attention to your data and making data-driven decisions. We want to start out here. This is page one. And that's the AGP report. So that's the ambulatory glucose profile. And it's a great place to start. It gives you sort of an overview of what's going on. As you can see, this report is in millimole per liter. That's because this client lives in Australia and that's what they use there. It's also what's used widely outside of the US. If you're in the US, you're using milligram per deciliter. To get from millimole per liter to milligram per deciliter, you have to multiply by 18. So when you see this range that says it's 3.9 millimole per liter up to 10 millimole per liter, that is the milligram per deciliter range of 70 up to 180. Let's go over the AGP report in detail so that you know what you're looking at. So up here, it sort of just says it's an AGP report. It tells you the date range and how many days that covers. That's 14 days. Let's start here on the left-hand side, and you can see again the date range. You can see the percent of time the sensor is active. So basically, my client is wearing the sensor all the time. And then you have the glucose ranges. So these are the target ranges here in gray. And you can see again the target range is 3.9 to 10 millimole per liter, so that's a 70 to 180 milligram per deciliter, as well as the other target ranges. And we want to be in the target range 70% of the time or more, and you can see that over here on the right hand side. You can also see the targets for all the other blood sugar ranges for low blood sugars, which is again 70, and then urgent low, which is 3, which is equivalent of 55 milligrams per deciliter. Next, we go down and look at the average glucose. So that's simply how much have the glucose been on average during this period, and that is 10.7 millimole per liter, which is 193 milligram per deciliter. We also have the GMI, which is right below that. And that's a really cool one because the GMI is an estimated A1C just based on the sensor glucose. So you can see here the GMI is expected to be 7.9%. That is assuming that the client's blood sugars continue to be as they are. You can also see the glucose variability below. That is at 23.5%. That's pretty good. We generally want it to be below 36%. And it's an indicator of how much a blood sugar is fluctuating. Now let's look at the right-hand side. Here you can see my client's actual time and ranges. So basically this means how much of the time are her blood sugars in the different ranges. Remember, we want it preferably to be in the target range, so our time and range, we wanted that to be 70% or higher. This is this range in the middle, and you can see right now my client is at 44%, so there's a little bit of room for improvement. We want to spend as little time in the very low as possible, but again, you can see the targets over on the left-hand side. Let's scroll down. This is a really cool graph. Here you see blood sugars as they fluctuate, you know, within the 24 hours. So the solid blue line are the averages. So here we can see on average how our blood sugars, you know, during the night, during midday, and then the gray or blue scrivation around it shows us how much we fluctuate. And then down in the bottom report here, we have the daily overviews. So you kind of can see what's contributing to the high and lows. I don't love this way of looking at the daily reports. I'll show you a better way to do that later. But this is the AGP report. Now you know what you're looking at. And that was just the first page of the report. If you do need to focus, I would suggest that you look at the following, that you look at your average glucose, that you look at your variability, that you look at your time and range, your GMI, as well as that overview graph. And remember, to get the most accurate GMI, you need a bit more than 14 days of data, preferably 90 days of data. It won't necessarily be exactly the same as your A1C, but the more data you have, the better of an indicator it is of what your A1C is going to be. So I start my more detailed analysis by looking at the overview graph. And when I look at this, I immediately zoom in on from 9 a.m. until 7 p.m. because that's where we're a little higher, right? So what I see here is I see a mid-morning rise as well as an afternoon rise. So now I want to dig deeper. I want to go into the daily graphs and start trying to figure out what is contributing to these higher blood sugars.
So what we do is we dig into the daily log. So what you're looking at here, so you can see all these different icons, is the green here is the long-acting insulin. This is the rapid-acting insulin. Here in the orange, we have how many carbs have been eaten. And you can see that up here illustrated as a little, you know, insulin pen, syringe, and an apple. But let's look through it. And just know that the only reason why this shows up in the report is because my client has manually logged it. These days, she did not log anything, but we see that increase in the mid-morning. We see that consistently day over day. But if we go up here, what you can see now is that actually my client eats around 8 a.m. and often blood sugars already start to climb before the meal and then continue to trail up throughout the mid-morning, which is also what we saw in the overview.
But now we have a better idea about what to focus on.
My client and I then had a discussion about what was going on in the morning, and we identified two behaviors. So the first one was that she was enjoying a coffee. It was just a black coffee, but she was enjoying a coffee every morning and she was not taking any insulin for it. The second thing was that she didn't quite think she was getting her carb count correct for the morning. She was giving herself insulin, but probably not for the right amount of carbs. So those are two very tangible things that she could then start to work on, and things that we wouldn't have known had we not looked at the Libre review report. And I do want to point out, not everyone needs to dose insulin for that coffee, but some people do. And by going and looking at the Libre report, it became clear for my client that she was one of those people who actually needed a little bit of insulin with her coffee to prevent those morning rises. So the other thing we noticed was that her blood sugars were also going up in the afternoon. So let's have a look at that.
So we go back to the daily reports. And here you go. Here you can see in the afternoon, we can see that whatever event is making blood sugars go up happens around 2 p.m. It's not entirely clear what's going on, as my client didn't necessarily log food and events every day, but my client and then had a conversation and we talked it through. And it turns out that most days that rise was after a meal, and usually that meal included a tortilla. We actually went back and we looked at that specific tortilla, looked at the nutrition label, and I realized that the carb count on the packaging was a little bit off. Basically, I think they'd been a bit too creative with how they listed the net carbs,
which was what my client was using to calculate her insulin doses.
This then allowed my client to dose for the right amount of carbs. Had the carb count been accurate, another option could have been that her carb ratio was off. So the carb ratio is, well, basically how many grams of carbs does one unit cover? So for example, a carb ratio of 1 to 10 means that one unit of insulin covers 10 grams of carbohydrates. But I do think you always want to consider if your carb count is accurate before you start changing your carb ratio. I usually try to only identify 1 to 3 things to work on, and with this client, we identified 3 things, and I'll show you the outcome shortly. But the reason why I'm only focusing on 1 to 3 things is that if we change too many things at once, it becomes hard to see what's effective and what's actually working. I always think it's helpful to read the blood sugar reports, but the more data that you add to your report, the more details you'll have and the easier it'll become to see where you need to make changes or what you need to do more of. So with this client, for example, she was tracking food and insulin, just not consistently, but even tracking a little bit helped with this report and helped with the analysis. We did the analysis in the last section of this video. Now let's have a look at what my client got out of downloading the report, doing the analysis, and start implementing data-driven changes. This is where we started. So as you can see here, her time in range was 44%. Average glucose was 10.7 millimole per liter, which is 193 milligrams per deciliter. And now let me show you what happened in only 9 days. This is the report. As you can see, her time in range is now 67%. Just a reminder, it was 44 when we started. Her average glucose is 9.2 millimole per liter, which is 166 milligrams per deciliter. And again, this is just in just over a week. And this improvement is not due to additional lows, as you can also see here. And let's look at the graph. See, we still have some of the highs in the AM, but the PM rise has come down significantly. And we didn't stop there. We continued to work together, and in just 5 weeks, she achieved some pretty incredible results. So let me show you. This is a report. As you can see, just in 5 weeks, she took her time in range to 89%.
That's an average glucose of 7.3 millimole per liter, which is equivalent to 131 milligram per deciliter.
In just 5 weeks, this client changed her time in range from 44% to 89%. Her GMI, so the estimated A1C, let me just show you. Here you go. See, it went from 7.9% to 6.5%. Thank you so much for watching this video on how to download and read the Freestyle Libre blood sugar reports. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give the video a like below and leave me a comment. Also, if you'd like to see more from me, remember to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. That way you'll be informed whenever I post new content. Thank you so much for watching.